In 1967, Andy Warhol acquired an image of Marilyn Monroe and began a series of color studies. He used the bright colors of the pop art movement. Using a selfie, you're going to make a quad of different images. Here is some of your classmates' work. Choose an image that is a large portrait, not one that you would have to crop and enlarge. In Illustrator, I'll click Open, and then navigate to the image I've saved on my desktop. Now I'll need to zoom out. That's Command or Control minus. Now that I can see the whole image, I'll want to know how big it is, so I'll type Command or Control R to get my rulers to show. The rulers are displaying across the top and down the left, and they're showing me points. I'd rather see inches, so with my control key, I'll click the ruler and choose inches from the drop-down menu. I can see that my image is about 20 by 25. I'll crop my image now by clicking on it with the selection tool and choosing Crop Image from the control panel. Now I'll use the crop handles to crop out everything except the head and shoulders. That'll make my image trace much easier. Then, by clicking Apply, the crop is complete. Now, to make my artboard the same size as the image, I'll get the artboard tool and resize my artboard. This is a tricky tool. You know, if you don't grab right on the handle, you may end up drawing a new artboard. Now, with the selection tool, find the drop-down menu that is to the right of the image trace button and choose 6 colors. We are converting a raster image into a vector shape. You can see these shapes now. Let me zoom in so you can see them better. They're not at all like the gradients of a JPEG. They're individual vector shapes. Now I'll click the expand button so that you can see each individual shape. The blue lines with very tiny blue handles show each individual shape. By clicking to the left on the pasteboard, I can deselect everything. And now, with the direct select tool, I can select individual shapes. The next step is going to be creating the 4 artboards. I'll zoom out, and then using the artboard tool, I'll copy the artboard by holding the Alt or Option key as I click and drag to the right. I'll do the same thing again, holding the Shift key to select both of these artboards, press Option or Alt, and then click and drag down. Now I have 4 artboards. Look in the Layers palette. You'll see all 4 artboards here. I'll lock 3 of them, so that I can work on just one layer. When I start my work on this first one and want to change this color to a bright pop art tint, use the Select drop-down menu to choose Same and then Fill Color. Now, as you can see, everything that is that one color on this artboard only is selected. I'll open my color palette and choose a warm tint for the lightest color shape. I'm going to use an orange that is above the middle here. When I click on it, all of the selected shapes are that bright pop art orange. My next step will be to choose the shape beside the first one. In my color palette, the tints are above the midline here, and my shades are below. The hues are in the middle. so I'll click this second shape. Select, same, fill color. I'll go over to my color palette and choose a slightly darker orange than I did last time. Now, all of those shapes have a darker fill. You can see now how using tints and shades is important, where the photograph went from light to dark. We will go from tint to shade. I'll choose a third shape, the next darker color. Select same, fill color, and now a darker red-orange. It will go on like this, from lighter to darker, giving the image a more positive than negative look. The last shape selected will be my darkest, almost maroon. It's time to create a background of cool colors. I imported a color wheel to help you see the warms and cools. The face is predominantly a warm orange. These are the warms and these are the cools. Complementary colors are opposites on the color wheel, so maybe I'll choose one of these blues. To select only these top white parts of the background, I'll use my direct selection tool and select them one at a time, holding my shift key. I'll zoom in to see better, then hold the shift key as I select each one. Remember to zoom in, Command or Control Plus, for detail work. As I am selecting each one, I see some other small white sections that need to be selected. Again, I'm holding my shift key to select multiple shapes. The reason I'm not using the Select drop-down menu is because I don't want to select any of the shapes from the teeth or the shirt. With my color palette open again, I'll choose a different bright blue. I'll zoom out to see how I like it. Now I'll choose a darker blue for these shapes, zooming in again for detail work. I'll choose a different dark blue for the shirt. I've completed all four of the portraits now and placed a color wheel next to them so that you can see how I arranged the warm and cool colors and the tints and shades. This small map shows you what you are asked to do in this assignment. Note that the top left and the bottom right both have a warm subject and a cool background. They both have the same thing, warm subject, cool background. And yet, the color choices on each one are quite different. I also looked at my complementary colors on the color wheel and decided to make her glasses a color that is complementary to the face. So here it's purple and a yellowy orange, here it's blue and orange, here it's red and green, and here it's green and red. To save and export this project, first choose Trim View from the View drop-down menu. That will clean up the edges. Then from the File menu, choose Export and Export As. Here, make sure that PNG is chosen from the format menu. Be sure that your initials are in the title. And we will not check Use Artboards this time because we want to see all four artboards. That's what you're going to see in the PNG. I'll ask for a white background and then I'll click OK. This will give me the PNG that I need to post to Brightspace.